It's Allie, and today I did a little chit-chat get ready with me. I spoke a little bit about what my life was like this past year and where I wanted to be in this new upcoming year. I also did use a few of my favorite products from last year that I'm hoping to get a video up on there for you guys too. So if you want to go ahead and see what I use and just sit down and chat with me, go ahead and keep watching. All right, I'm gonna prep my eyes using the Pretty Vulgar eyeshadow primer. I do have a video to this. I will leave that below. All right, let's get started. It is 2021. Happy New Year, everybody. 2020, what a year, right? I'm not gonna bore you with the whole, I know we had a rough year and blah, blah, blah. But honestly though, what a year. I feel like it was revolutionary in so, so many ways, both good and bad. Personally, I would say. For me, I feel like when I personally go and watch some makeup videos and things like that, it's because it is a nice escape for me. So if there are others like that, I hope that this is a good escape for you. So I'm not going to go ahead and talk about the horrible things that have happened. Let's talk about the good. So personally, I experienced, I feel, a lot of growth, a lot of personal growth. I'm using the Tati Beauty Palette. Yeah, I feel like it was definitely a year that changed me. Something that I personally needed was to slow down. And as we know, the world shut down, and that's literally what caused me to stop and slow down. It was very necessary for me. For my mental health, I feel. I know a lot of people definitely struggled during like their quarantine. And I'm not gonna lie, like I obviously did when I stopped to think about what was actually going on in the world. Of course, that was definitely overwhelming. But besides all of that, it was very nice for me to focus on my girls and my husband and myself. Also, quarantine, everything happened like right before my birthday. It was a lot. It was a lot to go on. I was trying to focus on like filming and things like that a little bit more. It was definitely easier in the beginning. Yeah, for those of you who don't know, I think, yeah, I did speak about this on my video when I finally returned to YouTube. My family and I did move. We moved like significantly further away, and I was still traveling back and forth to see clients and run my business, and it was good. I mean, we were able to see our family every month. We were able to, obviously, I was able to see my clients every month. A few times we were there like more than once a month, and it was, I mean, it worked out because obviously like our families loved that we were able to still see them, and my clients loved that I was still able to take care of them. But I'm not gonna lie, it was obviously taking a toll on my family as far as like the travel and the prepping and that type of stuff. It was a lot. Thankfully, my husband's job was super flexible, so he was able to work from home. But when we were traveling, it was just a lot traveling with my two little ones in the car for so many hours and trying not to stop. And then it was always tough when it was like snowing. I mean, I didn't want to put my family's lives in danger just so I can go and cover people's gray hair. I mean, I'm gonna just be blunt about it. It wasn't worth it. And thankfully, a lot of my clients were very understanding. But yeah, so that being said, once the quarantine and all of that happened, obviously we were forced to shut down. We were not able to take clients. I have to say it was actually kind of nice getting a little break. That being said, I'm not like undermining the situation at all, because obviously it was horrible, everything that was going on. All right, I'm gonna prep my face. I'm using the Tarte Clean Slate Timeless Smoothing Primer. I'm also using products that were some of my favorites from 2020. I'm gonna try to make a video. So if you are interested in that, I will leave the link to that below. Like I said, I don't wanna talk about like the horrible things that happened because it gets to me. Let's focus on the good. Let's focus on the good things. We were able to enjoy the beautiful scenery that's around us. Where we live is like absolutely stunning. I'm so happy. I'm so happy with our decision to move. And I love being able to just like walk outside and like a short drive away and you're in the mountains. It's my favorite. But we were able to enjoy a little bit of hiking, lots of cooking, things like that. I'm gonna use the Wet n Wild Dewy Foundation. So I was also able to work a lot on my spirituality. So that's something that I've been wanting to do. And for those of you who are not into like spirituality or Christianity or anything like that, then you might want to skip through this, but maybe not. But basically, I was just able to refocus on my spirituality. For those of you who don't know, I did grow up going to church every single week. Every week we were there. And my church was not like, I guess, your typical church if you think about it. Although I shouldn't really speak because I can't speak for all of you. But from my understanding, compared to a lot of my peers, my church was very different. It was like an all-day affair and it was actually so much fun. I loved it. I really did love going to church. Of course, like when I reached my little rebellious teenage years, I just would rather have hung out with my friends and like go out and do teenage stuff. No, church was like a really big part of my life. And although I never, I guess, like lost faith and that type of stuff, I did stop going to church. But that's something that I always said growing up was that like I wanted to raise my family in church and with the same beliefs. It's just something that, like, it shaped me. It really did. And it's something that I wanted for my children. So, obviously, now being a mother, and this looks very light for my skin right now. I think the light is, like, a little bit. Let's lower that. That's something that I was actually able to focus on again, which was really nice and honestly, like, therapeutic, especially with everything that was happening in the world. I needed it. I needed it so badly for, like, just my well-being. I worked on a lot of things that I'm still working on a lot of things, but I worked on a lot of things that I thought I like could never change about myself, and I really didn't want to change. And as I like learned a little bit more, I realized that it's not healthy. So it was really nice. I was able to focus on my physical health as well. Again, for those of you who don't know me, working out and like being physically active and in shape and fit has always been like, I guess, a passion of mine. I don't know. It's so funny because my husband's the same way. And we literally talk about when both of us, we were like 10 years old. He's older than me, so whatever. I remember waking up at like 6 a.m. or like 6:30. And there was like, it was called Fit TV. And there was a guy, I think his name was Gilad. Does anyone else know what I'm talking about? I literally was like a 10-year-old, I think between 10 and 12. I don't remember. But between 10 and 12, I would be waking up every morning to work out with Gilad. And it was like the best thing ever. But he would just like work out. And I remember sometimes he'd be working out like on a cliff or like at a beach or something like that. But he was my favorite. And I would wake up every morning and work out. And I remember doing like crunches every night and just going for runs. And I don't know, I just really always love working out. So it's funny. And my husband, he apparently would do the same thing as a little boy. He would work out with Gilad. And I don't know, I just think it's really funny. So that's something that I was able to work on. I did get the Peloton as well as many, many other people. However, I will say, I've been wanting the Peloton for about like 7 or 8 years or however long it's been around, probably longer than that, because I've always loved spin, like absolutely love cycle and that type of stuff. It was always my favorite. Like I remember the first time I took a spin class, I was like, oh, that's amazing. I love it. So I finally got the Peloton. I ride it literally every single day. The other classes are great. I was doing a lot of their other classes while I was waiting for my bike delivery. And honestly, I personally think that it's all the rage, but I do think you need to like, you don't need to, but I think it helps obviously if you like spin, and you need a lot of self-discipline. You need to make it worth it, in my opinion. You need to be able to want to get up and get on that bike every day or do a workout every day or however it is. So that was really nice. I was able to work on my physical fitness again. I was like feeling so good, feeling healthy, working on my mental health, working on my spirituality, working on my physical health. And things were good. Things were really, really good. And I'm using the contouring palette by Wet n Wild. I'm hitting pan on this. This is so good, you guys. Wet n Wild is one of my favorite brands ever. So life was really good. I was just focusing on the things that I felt really mattered. And of course, with like so many crazy things going on in the world, all, you know, again, I'm not gonna get into it, but like the losses and all of that, it really just helped put things into perspective for me. And I'm like, I really just need to focus on what I want to focus on. Because I guess I was prioritizing things that didn't matter. My whole thought process was like, let me do all of this now while I can, so that way I can really enjoy my family and myself later. I was like, let me get this all out of the way now and then slow down. But obviously with like everything happening, it kind of like forced me to be like, you know, there might not be a later. So, oh, just the thought of that. Whew. We're not doing this. We're not getting emotional. Why did I have to do my eye makeup first? Because like I was not expecting to get emotional. We're good. We are all good. But anyways, yeah. So that, excuse me. I'm not even going to like pretend to whatever. We're going to get past that. But anyway, my point to that is like, don't take tomorrow for granted. I don't know. There may not be a tomorrow. So stop. If you do what I did, I like wiped all my makeup off from crying. If you are like how I was, / kind of am still, I'm working on it. This is what I'm telling you. It's like a work in progress. Stop, like for everything. Stop pushing things off. Stop waiting for tomorrow. Stop saying like, eventually you'll do this, or you'll call that person when you can, or whatever, because you never know. That being said, it was nice to just like focus on the things that really matter. And I felt like me, like I felt like myself again, especially like with working out. It's like, honestly, I've been so busy with like work and that type of stuff that I really just kept pushing off working out for the longest time. Like I hadn't been to an actual gym for myself to work out probably since I was pregnant with my first, so like 4 years. And I did like at home workouts and all of that, but I haven't done it regularly in probably like 3 years. So like here and there, I would do it always. Like I need to be active. For me, that was like super, super important to be physically healthy and mentally healthy. And that being said, it was time for the world to like reopen. And I was very nervous that I would basically just like lose everything that I worked so hard on. And it was a little bit different because this time it was just me going back and forth. I wasn't bringing my family around. I don't know. I just thought it was a lot. And obviously like everything was still happening. It didn't just disappear. It still hasn't disappeared. But I just felt better about it if it was just me going, taking care of my clients and coming home. And that was hard. That was like the first time I really was ever away from my children. And then it kind of made me think about like, here I am making this progress, prioritizing things, but then like leaving my family behind when it was time for me to take care of my clients. I'm using the Alamad Cosmetics blush and my Luxie brush. I love it. I was trying to let my clients know, like, I'm not going to be available all the time like I was. And it was just time for me to slow down. And as the world would have it, my family and I were presented an opportunity that we took, and with that it did require my business to change. So I actually did scale back, close down, and I'm doing things a little bit differently now. It was very bittersweet. So bittersweet because like this was something that I worked so hard on, and thank God like it was so successful from day one. So this is the Artist Couture highlight. Thankfully, I'm not trying to like brag or anything like that, but my business was like super, super successful from day one. And not many people could say that. So, whoa, that was way too much highlight. So it was very bittersweet, but I knew it's something that like I had to do. I had to do something I wanted to do. Like if I could kind of just like fold the map a little bit and make these locations closer together so I can take care of my clients and still be like a present mom and wife, it would have been great. But things changed. My husband's schedule was not as flexible as it was, and it was just time for a change. There was like just a lot happening in 2020. So that was kind of like my year in review, I guess. And here we are in the new year. Now that we are in 2021, I wanted to just kind of, sit down here, chat with you, give you a little bit of background of like just a brief little update of my life and talk about our goals. I'm using this, it's called Brow Chow by Item. So for me, I want to continue working on the things that I started working on in 2020 again, which is more like myself, my family, our health, our spirituality. I want to just basically continue what I was doing when I was feeling really good. One thing for sure that I need to work on is drinking more water, as simple as that sounds, but I definitely don't drink enough water. I also want to eat a little bit better. I'm not terrible, but I think I definitely take advantage of the fact that I guess I have or had a quicker metabolism. I definitely took it for granted in my younger years, and now I'm kind of like, I guess, holding on to whatever I can hold on to before I really slows down. I don't know. I'm very picky with who is in my life. I know some people might think that's weird. I know some people might be like, what do you think you are, a celebrity with like who you allow to see certain things? But I don't care what they say. I'm just very protective over the ones I love. With that, I have made some friendships. I have lost some friendships, and I'm very okay with it. And that might sound cold, but I personally don't think that in a real friendship you should have to filter yourself or basically be told that your voice doesn't matter. No time for that in my life. What else do I want to focus on for 2021? I want to be more consistent, and it's been very hard for me to be consistent because life happens. I just try to do too much, but then with that, I'm thinking maybe like I'll set a schedule or something like that to help be more consistent as far as like the content that I put out there. I do feel like with everything that has happened, a lot of people have been trying to, I guess, like make it in the content creating world, whether it be on Instagram or YouTube or whatever it may be. And I think that's great, but obviously that makes it a little bit more challenging because it's like you need to stand out from everyone else. But I also feel like you need to be true to yourself. So I do need to work on putting more stuff on Instagram, but I can't bring myself to do some of these trendy things that are just like not me. I'm sorry. And this is no shade to anyone who does it, but like, I'm not gonna go ahead and do like a trendy little Instagram reel or whatever because it's trendy and I'm gonna get views. Like, I don't know. To me, it's like I'd rather be authentic and just do the things that I really like than do something. And I feel like a sellout if it means like I need to make this reel if I wanna make it on like the Explore page or whatever. I'm like, you know what? People will find me, they'll either like me or they won't, and that's that. And if I get more followers, great. And if not, it's okay. Because you know what? I do this because I enjoy it. I think it's fun. I think it's like a nice creative outlet for me. And I think, if even just one person enjoys watching my videos, then I'll keep doing it. And if nobody watches it, I'll still keep doing it because I enjoy doing it. But yeah, so that little rant. I do want to put more content out there though. So I'm gonna try to be a little bit more consistent with the things that I put out there. I think now that I'm not traveling back and forth as much or anything like that, I will be able to be more active in the community that I live in now and help more people because I love helping people, obviously. Like, I love making other people happy. So I'm gonna try to do that. All right, that was the ColourPop gel liner. This is the Wet n Wild Breakup Proof eyeliner. Another thing is with wanting to bring out more content, and I've always been someone who has pride themselves in like, I don't care what people think and blah, blah, blah. And that's true to a certain extent because like realistically, I think everyone cares about what at least one person thinks of them, right? But I'm gonna try my best to really just not care. Like, obviously in order to get content out there, I need to be taking pictures, recording videos, and putting stuff out there, reaching out to people, and not holding myself back. I am learning to ask for help more. That's a big one for me for 2021. I am someone who never, ever, ever, ever asks for help like with anything. In fact, even if I have way too much going on, way too much on my plate, and I can't handle it, I still would offer help before asking for help. So this year I'm going to be working really hard on asking for help. And so far, I think I've been pretty good at that. Even something little. Obviously, I want to enjoy the moment and be with my family. But if we're out and I'm like, this would be a really good photo opportunity, I will go and ask my husband to take a picture of me. Sometimes they don't come out that great, but at least I ask. But yeah, asking for help in any way I think is important. I'm going to use this mascara by Collab. But yeah, I'm going to be really trying to just continue this journey of self-love and self-help. I also want to read more books. That's something that I think I would enjoy. Of course, my excuse is like, I have no time. Like, when am I going to really read a book? But I can make time, or I can do an audiobook. But if I'm going to read a book, I'd rather like actually read a book. It's so funny because for the longest time, my husband's been wanting to move. I was like, No, I love it here. We need to raise our family here. And obviously we moved, and I'm like, what was I doing? Like, why did I want to stay there so badly? Because looking back now, yes, it has its perks, but those perks were not perks for us. Now, since we have moved and I'm like so into where we live and like the wilderness and the mountains and the lakes and stuff like that, now I'm like, what if we move somewhere else? Like, what if we move like really far away? My husband's like, I'll live wherever. I don't care. So I don't know if moving is like in our future. I have no idea what the future holds, obviously. I'm like way more open to that than I've ever been. Again, because I'm realizing like what really matters. And it's funny because I feel like I've always known in the back of my head like what actually matters, obviously, you know. But again, because I took everything for granted, I was like, they'll always be there, you know, everything that I really need and care about will always be there. But that's not true. Yeah, I don't know, we'll see. I'm using the Elemad Dulce lip liner. Basically, 2020, as horrible as it was something that I personally needed. I needed to be forced to stop. I needed to slow down. I had to do it. And I needed to really focus on the things that make my heart happy. Like, I had to focus on the things that I care, like deeply, deeply care about. Not to say that I didn't care about my business or my clients, because obviously, like, I love what I do. I absolutely love what I do. And my clients, honestly, I've known them for like, so many of them I've known for like 10 plus years. It's so hard, and they're like family. And when all this craziness settles down, I want to see so many of you. Like, if you guys are watching, I miss you guys so much. I'm not going to cry. I already got emotional already, and I'm not going to do it again. But I miss you guys so much. So yeah, obviously it's not that I didn't care about my business or my clients, but like moments with my daughters that I will never get back, I'm actually enjoying, and I'm not missing any milestones or anything like that, especially because they're growing so quickly. And I look now and I'm like, oh my gosh, I would have been missing all of this. So I'm very happy to be with my family, but I do miss my clients. That was my Abu Dhabi Soft Matte Lip Cream by NYX. We're going to use Body Count by Jeffree Star. So there's a lot of different goals for me. Some a little bit more deep than others. Drinking more water, trying to get more sleep, getting more content out. But definitely still working on like my physical health, my mental health, focusing on my family, and just being the best person I could be. That's like all I want. The nice thing is everything that makes me happy are things that make me a better person. So by focusing on my happiness, I'm focusing on being a better person. And I think that's great. So I want to continue doing that is basically what I'm trying to say. I also want better skin. I also want better skin for 2021. So I'm working really hard on my skin journey and my knowledge of skincare and that type of stuff. I'm gonna wrap it up because I went off on a tangent here. I really hope that as difficult and complicated and, you know, all of those things that 2020 was, I hope that it did bring some type of light into your life like it did for me. I hope that this new year brings you some light and love and all those good things too. I know it's just like another day, you know, but I guess in a way it's nice to have that idea that it's a fresh new start because it is a new year, even though it's just the next day. Like, things didn't just magically get better maybe one day, but I hope to be seeing you, or I hope that you guys will be seeing me more often. I hope that you enjoyed this, and if you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe if you aren't subscribed already. Ring the bell for notifications. Stay happy. Let me know what goals you have for 2021. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.